I don't think so. Yung mga kabataan eh, karamihan kanila eh, nangangako pa sila eh. Ito ang aming gagawing program of government. Wala naman silang performance. Eh tayo, hindi na tayo pangangako. Ako nagawa ko na, I've been there. And I've done that. I want to go back because I'll do more. Yung housing, no? We were able to put up the city hall to what it is now because when we were elected in the 60s, the city hall then was in, which is now the Ramon Magsaysay High School across Nepacu Mart. We had this development of housing for the poor. We had Tondo Foreshore. We had Bagong Barrio, where you have the Balintawak area, part of it. Is Quezon City. And then we started putting up the Bliss apartment, yung Bagong Lipunan, na housing constructed on land owned by the government. So that selling price definitely lower than any kind of similar development. Yung pagpaparating ng other basic services, kaya mga lighting. Yung lighting was an important component, no, of a priority because in the surveys, it showed na yung mga mothers o yung mga kababaihan, they suffer from anxiety. Pag dumating yung gabi, yung sinasabi natin yung twilight o yung darkness, they feel that something might happen to them. Bug snatching, sexual harassment. So nung palagay tayo ng lighting sa mga major streets, so those are, I think that we really have started foundation. Really tried our best. Not only to provide yung basic concern, but at the same time, to continue to bring together a program that would bring to reality the vision of our leaders then. I was able to bring about the realization of the vision of our leaders when Quezon City was created. And second, I laid the foundation on the matter of education, the matter of business development, of coming up with a atmosphere of business, friendly and sustained, and fourth, the desire of the people na mag-ari ng kapirasong lupa, makapagtayo ng kanyang bahay, na in time, eventually, will be a Filipino home. Well, ako ang aking ano dyan sa nakikita ko yung lack of Medicare, yung first 100 days mo, kailangan magbigay ka na muna o magbayad ka ng premium sa PhilHealth and then bigyan mo ng family card itong mga mahihirap para in any case of emergency or immediate medical assistance, magagamit nila. Pangalawa, I think you also have to do to improve quality education. You have to address yung situation of the human resource, no? Yung the plight of teachers. Because every year, well, nakikita mo, they're protesting about higher compensation. Of course, that is the direct responsibility of the national government. But for those who, well, we claim that we are the rich city, kamukha ngayon, yung allowance na binibigay na city na 2,000 pesos, ito pa rin yung allowance na ibinigay ko when I left almost 9 years ago. Pangatlo, yung retraining ng mga teachers, I started that to strengthen nga and improve the quality of teaching yung on 3 subjects, yung science, mathematics, at saka English. Summer, we send them to UP, to Ateneo, and the course is being paid for by the Quezon City government. And then third, yung matter of peace and order. Kasi ang problema sa peace and order, no matter what we do and claim na yung crime rate ay bumababa, ang talagang ano ng tao, eh paano hindi bababa yan eh? Hindi na kami nagre-report eh. Dahil lalo lang lalaki yung aming problema sa gastos kung i-report natin. And this is reflected in the fact that here you have an instance of a city jail ng capacity 400 ang nakadetained doon ngayon, more than 4,000. This is a picture where there is a denial of justice, ang presumption of innocence is there. That there is yung kanilang day in court, and yet, ang kanilang living condition is worse. They have already been convicted. Ang point ko dyan, during a time that I was vice governor, which I implemented, and when I was mayor, na for those who are detained, unable to have lawyers, or ang kanilang hearing has been delayed and delayed, for those who have already served the minimum possible sentence, minimum of that possible sentence, pwede mo nang pakawala. Kasi mas intensya naman, na-serve na yung kalahati ng kanyang sentence.